Okay, today we have to discuss NMR spectroscopy. Okay, I am going to record this topic, so don't make noise. Okay, so NMR, NMR spectroscopy. So what is meant by NMR? Any nuclear magnetic resonance. NMR mean what? Nuclear magnetic resonance. Nuclear magnetic resonance spectroscopy. So what is the introduction? Just so what is the use of this? Why you are studying of the NMR? More than 50 years ago, we don't know anything. NMR, IR, spectroscopy. Just probably this is the medicine, this is the things, this is sodium chloride. We don't know the exact structure. But after invention of NMR, after invention of NMR or IR or ultraviolet, we know the different atoms structural elucidation. Structural elucidation means, so what is the structure? For example, sodium chloride. What is the structure? Sodium chloride. What are the atoms present? We know the sodium chloride means, just we know. But ordinary people, sodium chloride means a rock salt, white crystalline powder. Then just he has taken the taste. Oh, this is the sodium salt. And this is the sugar. Both are white. If you are powder it, you can do the powder, sodium chloride and sugar molecule. They are in white in color. Unless you taste it. If you taste it, then only this is the sugar, this is the salt. But in the present day, the millions of compounds, millions of medicines are there. The tablets, capsules, all are in powder shape, all are in white color. So how can you know the structure? How can you know? So that is depend upon the structural elucidation. Structure. For example, mass spectroscopy. Mass spectroscopy. Mass means molecular weight. Molecular weight. The mass spectroscopy gives the weight of the molecular. For example, glucose. Is glucose molecular C6H12O6. This molecular. And sodium chloride. Sodium 23 and Cl 35.5. Like that, its molecular weight. And methane, 16. Oxygen, 16. Like it gives the molecular weight of the compound. And IR, yesterday we have studied the IR spectroscopy. That gives the functional group. That gives only functional group. For example, OH group. OH, double bond, alkene, triple bond, alkyne, chloride, Cl. CHO, aldehyde, ketone, CO, ester, COOR, like this functional groups give the good information. The information about the functional groups we can find by IR spectroscopy. And the molecular weight gives the mass spectroscopy. But NMR gives what? The NMR gives the data, number of hydrogens present in the molecule. How many hydrogens are present? How many carbons are present? We know that. NMR, there are three types of NMR are there. Proton NMR means hydrogen. We know that. If you take the sample in the machine, it gives the number of hydrogens present in the, how many hydrogens are present in the compound. We can know that you have to take the HNMR. or protonym. In the C13 NMR, number of carbons are present. How many carbons are present? And phosphorus NMR. So number of phosphorus molecules present in the given cell. So that type of things are we know by using the NMR. So last 50 years, so we are using this one. So in Hyderabad, almost 10 NMR spectroscopy at Central University, Usmani University, IIT, and Dr. Reddy's lab is Nacharam.
Voice loud, sir.
What? Don't make noise. Last moment.
Voice loud, clear.
Voice not clear? Hello? Okay.
Sir.
So now, so we are going to discuss about the nuclear magnetic resonance. It gives the number of hydrogens present in the molecule, number of carbons present in the molecule, in the sample, or number of phosphorus present in the sample. We have to know this. So how can you study this? NMR. Okay? So nuclear magnetic resonance spectroscopy, actually it involves the spin in every atom having the spin state. We know that the spin quantum number, that is the place of and minus. The spin state, all other with the like revolving around the nucleus. The electrons are revolving. So in an orbital, one is upside, one is the downside. We know that orbitals, the electrons feel like a spin quantum number. Means spin is active nuclei. When they are placed in the magnetic field, that is rotating either place of or minus. So mean a spinning charge generates some magnetic field. For example, Earth is revolving around the sun. It generates a magnetic field. There is a north pole and south pole. So revolving around the nucleus, the fast moving, the revolution of the electron, revolution of the Earth. So it gives the water magnetic generation, magnetic field, like this. The resulting spin magnetic moment, we can say that magnetic moment, nu. So always the new generation, when that the spin charges, the nuclear charges are spinning, it generates the magnetic moment is directly proportional to the spin. That nu is directly proportional to spin. So the nuclei may have integral spins, mean 1, 2, 3, or fractional plus of minus of or 3 by 2 or 5 by 2 or 0 spin also. So depend upon the nucleus. Depend upon the nucleus. Carbon, hydrogen, phosphorus, fluorine. Okay? Some of the examples we have to see. Hydrogen of C12, 1, C13, 0, N14 of like this examples. So here the nuclear spin states in a hydrogen nucleus. Two types of nucleus, that is the place of, that is revolving, mean that anti-clockwise there, like this. See, so this direction. So this direction, okay, this direction. So it is mean clockwise direction, anti-clockwise, or clockwise direction. Like this means the clockwise direction, clockwise direction. And this is the anti-clockwise. This clockwise direction, it is an anti-clockwise direction, okay. One is the place of, and another one is the mean two spin states are present in. So in our syllabus only hydrogen is there, not carbon 13, only hydrogen nucleus, proton NMR is there, just proton. not free certificate. Okay, number of hydrogens present. That type of questions will come. Okay, how many hydrogens are present? How many peaks are present in a given sample? Exactly, compulsory will give 5 marks question from this chapter. Any more question? Okay. So two spins are there, plus of y. Okay. Next. See, the plus of is called the alpha. The spin energy states.
Sir.
Alpha. Yes.
Sir, minus and clockwise, sir.
Anti-clockwise. Clockwise direction. Minus ante clockwise direction. Plus ante anti-clockwise direction. Ikkada unne chudu. Spin tirustune chudu. Okate emi ikkada.
Yes sir, yes sir.
Okate emi ila. Spins are moving.
Okay sir.
Spins are moving like this. One is alpha and one is the beta. Okay, spin energy. Magnetic field is the BJ. We can say the magnetic field is the BJ. Okay. Two spin states exist, plus of and minus. One is the alpha energy level and beta. Okay. So both are in opposite direction. Actually, that's magnetic field. One is the lower energy and another thing is higher energy. The higher energy is the beta spin, mean minus one, beta spin or minus. And the lower energy is the plus of or alpha. This is the only way. Mean both are in opposite direction in the external field. In the external field. See this one. For example, in a strong magnetic field, B0, that is B0, the spins of the hydrogen atom. So two spins are there, plus of and minus. So in the minus of, that is a higher energy level, and plus of is the lower energy level. So both are in opposite direction. Look, one is this one, down arrow mark, and this is the forward. So both are plus or minus of forming. One is the down, one is the up arrow mark. So mean both are opposite direction, plus up and minus. So that are two spins. So one is the minus up is the higher energy state, energy level, comparison energy level. Higher energy level is the minus solid against the applied field. Or another one is the plus up is the lower energy state. The energy separation depends on the magnetic field, the energy separation. So depend upon the magnetic field. It's a strong magnetic field, strong separation. Weak magnetic field, weak separation. So depend upon the B0, that is the magnetic field. If you increasing the magnetic field, that increases the main separation is more. For example, B0, here delta E is equal to KV0 or H. H means that is E is equal to H nu, that is the Planck quantum state and frequency. If your frequency is increasing, means energy is increased. Wavelength is decreased. So if energy is increased, that is minus of E is the upside and higher energy level and plus of E is the lower energy level. So both are in opposite direction. The energy separation in the increasing order of the magnetic field. This is one formula we can say Larmor equation. Delta E is equal to KB0 and H nu can be transformed. So finally nu is equal to gyrometric ratio, this one gamma by 2 pi B0, strength of the. So gamma is a constant which is different for the each atomic nucleus like carbon, hydrogen, oxygen. So now more nucleons will be in the lower energy aligned with the magnetic field. Mean when the nucleons absorb the photon, but the quantum energy, photon means the quantum energy. In the radio frequency, in the case of IR, infrared, but in NMR, the radio frequency, the lower energy, energy is very less. Energy is very less. The radio frequency, mean after rate, that is radioactivity, mean visible in the magnetic field. Gamma, X-ray, the higher energy level. Below the visible, that is the after red VGR, then the radio waves. So, lower energy, less energy. The frequency is very less. So, the radio frequency range and align against the magnetic field, it emits radio frequency when it drops back to its original. So, how they are absorbed? For example, the absorption of energy in the photon, quantized energy. When the sample is absorbed, then it changes to lower energy to high. It changes to lower energy to high. A second effect of strong magnetic field, when a spin, mean active hydrogen atom, is placed in a strong magnetic field, it begins to precess. What is meant by precess? P-R-E-C-E-S-S. Precess. Precess means, for example, the Earth is revolving around the sun. Like that, electron, the movement of the nucleus. Movement of the nucleus stops. It begins when the sample is placed in an NMR machine. When it stored the photon energy, the energy taken by the sample, it starts the spin, mean it begins to precess. Begins mean it revolves, started the revolving. The operation of an NMR electrometer, spectrometer, depends on this. The movement of the spin, the precess, every atom, hydrogen, carbon, oxygen. So, different types of molecules, ethanol, carbohydrate, methanol, many compounds are there. So, every molecule having the such spins when they are taking the energy, the photon, then it starts the process, meaning revolve. Okay? Then only the graph will come. So, we have to know the number of hydrogens are like this. If this is the B0, is the external magnetic field, this one. So, this is the external magnetic field. If you put the sample here, so what happened? It will start the rotation, like rotation. Meaning, lower energy to higher. It means, it begins to revolve, precess. Okay? So see this, the RF here in the magnetic field mean radio frequency energy. The sample is absorbed the radio frequency, then it starts to begin new zero. Magnetic movement, new zero mean magnetic movement. It starts to begin process. So mean when energy is absorbed, that so a lower energy to higher. Okay, when take the, so see, reference energy, I mean the frequency matching in the normal equation, you know the lambda that is introduced to at a right angle to the external field. The precessing nuclei will be absorb energy and the magnetic moment will be flip it. Flip it means turn the rotation. When absorb the radiation, it turns, mean minus up. This excitation is in the. Okay. Now, nuclear magnetic resonance, NMR. Resonance means what? In spectroscopy, in NMR spectroscopy, the resonance due to the absorption of energy, absorption means sample taking the energy by photon energy, quantized energy. It starts to begin precessing nucleus. starts to revolving. And turns the flip means starts to turn. When the taking the energy, it turns it. If it's a nuclear spin from lower energy state to higher energy state. Means the lower energy state to higher energy. Lower energy is there, then when lower energy sample take the energy and it flip it, means turn the rotation, means precessizing, means revolving around the spin. The precessizing spin induces an oscillating. The spin means when revolving, that induces an oscillating. Oscillating magnetic means just like the movement up and down. Oscillating means up and down. Oscillating magnetic field that is recorded as a single by the instrument. Our instrument, when the oscillation starts, it will record. Mean, just listen, sample, any sample, sugar sample or any sample, taking in a spec, in a machine, that machine takes, absorbs the photon energy, it starts the flipping, mean begins to precising, and it turns into the spin from lower energies to higher energy. Then precising or revolving spin induces an oscillating magnetic field, oscillation field. This oscillation recorded by the instrument. Then we will take one graph. So we have to know the mean depend upon the oscillation. The oscillation start when precession mean flipping mean energetic, like that. So depend on like that will give the number graph. Means signal will come depend upon the oscillating. So number of oscillations mean number of hydrogen, one hydrogen little, five hydrogen more oscillation, like that it will record and give the that is the nuclear magnetic resonance. Okay, it's depend upon the magnetic field. The proton spin energy difference is being, if you clarity want the 500 megahertz, 100 megahertz in the world, and as 100 megahertz, but it will be give the clearly at 270-360 in Hyderabad, not 500. 500 is so much of cost, almost 10 crore rupees one. Even 200 megahertz NMR machine, crore, more than 1 crore. Okay? In our research center also, CSIR labs, only 200 capacity megahertz instrument. So what is this? This is the magnetic field. It's not constant, but it approximately the Earth. So our Earth globe containing the approximately 10 to 4 torus. 10 to 4. Our Earth containing the approximately the magnetic field 10 to 4 torus at ground level. But our instrument in modern NMR spectrometer is a powerful than the our Earth, almost up to 20 torus. So mean if more the energy, the more suppression takes place. So in 100 megahertz spectrum, the suppression is very less. It's not clear. We cannot able to identify the photons. Whereas in 500, it's a very clear, beautiful suppression takes place. But that is so much of cost. So now we are using the so many in 100 or 270 megahertz suppression. Mean all peaks are separatedly very clear by using of this 200 or 270 megahertz in a moment. In NMR, so this is the NMR spectrometer, the instrument. So this is the sample. Okay, this is the sample, the test tube. Okay, this is the test tube. Okay, Here we have taken whatever we want from the sample. For example, sugar. Sugar contain how many hydrogens? We do. How many hydrogens present mean? You have to take the sugar sample in this. Then that sample is present in between the north pole and south pole. Mean two magnetic fields. Mean B0. That is external magnetic field. Magnetic power. So this magnetic power, and in the magnetic field we know that when energy taking that radio frequency, the radio frequency, so this is the coil or a radio frequency coil, when the sample, when sample absorbs the radio frequency, that is a blue color line transmitter, so absorb the sample in presence of magnetic field, is flipping, it starts the rotation, revolve, resizing, mean that it convert the lower energy to higher energy, then oscillation start. So that oscillation record the graph. That is the second. Okay, but it is not there in our syllabus. But for example, I am telling you. Okay. Diamagnetic anisotropy. So here diamagnetic anisotropy means shielding by valence electrons. Mean every atom containing the valence electron. For example, carbon 1s2, 2s2, 2p2. So valence electrons are 2p2. Mean the 2s, 1s2, 2s2. Mean first orbit, second orbit. Mean valence. So that valence electrons only shielding the effect. Mean diamagnetic. Anisotropy means, see, this is the, here this is the diagram, anisotropy diagram. Here this is the applied field, this is the induced field, applied field and induced field. When the sample taking the absorption of energy, these are the valence electrons, sample containing the valence electrons. Valence electrons shield the nucleus from the full effect of the applied field. This is applied field. Applied field means both magnetic fields. When applied field induces the circulation, this applied field induces the circulation over the valence electrons. This generates the magnetic field. This means that valence electron generate the magnetic field which are opposite to the applied field. Mean this one, this valence electron, these are the valence electrons, the black one, valence electron, generates the magnetic field that is exactly opposite to the applied field. This is called the anisotropy. So anisotropy means what? That when the applied field, the photon absorb the energy, it starts the circulation, that valence electrons generates the magnetic field which is opposite to the applied field. This is called the anisotropy. Okay. Proton differ in the shielding. We will look the, so this is the last topic today. Tomorrow we will start the chemical shift. So now, proton differ in their shielding. What is shielding are there? All different types of protons in the molecule have different amount of shielding. Different. They all respond differently. Mean different types of atoms respond different. In the magnetic field, the applied field, different protons, different samples, different movement, they are different. Acids, halides, ketones, alkyls, there are different types of molecules respond the different in the magnetic field and appear in different places in the spectrum. So one is appeared higher level, one is appeared lower level, simple alkanes appeared, downfield and acids function to a higher level, like that they are showing the, I will give that after completion of my chemical shift, I will show which field, which compound will come, which compound gives the spectra in what side exactly, we have to know after looking. For example, this is the spectrum, NMR spectrum. For example, here spectrum of acetal, yeah, CH3C. So here the CHO is appear here at 8th position. It's a lower field. And CH3 appear in the 2 position. This is the chemical shift, I will tell you. So it is a downfield. This is the shielding, depend upon the shielding and deshielding, higher and lower. Okay. So tomorrow we will see the chemical shift. Okay. So today I have to complete the anisotropy, and this is the spectrum, downfield, upfield. So just 0 is the down upfield and 10 is the downfield. Less shielded protons appear in lower level and highly shielded proton. Highly shielded proton, hydrogen, simple hydrogen is the nearer to 0. Mean high upfield. We can say up first hand 0. 1, 2, 3, 4, 10. So 10 is the lower, 1 is the higher up field in a spectrum. Okay. So do you understand this one? So I will take the attendance.
So I will take the attendance.
Hello?